My name is Gary Friedman, and I was sent to the South Pacific island of Fiji to observe the puppetry groups run by the Fiji Red Cross. During my week on the island, I was swept off my feet in an intense puppetry workshop. This film will give you a brief insight into my discoveries on the island.
Tomorrow morning, any time to suit you. Nine o'clock, we'll be there. And he'll just bring his portfolio with you. And it was just that he's been sent by AusCross and he's worked with AusAid before. And I just thought he'd like to brief you on what he's doing and what have you.
The puppet program the Fiji Red Cross Society goes way back in 1996. We used to have this peer education program for HIV/AIDS and drug abuse. And we used to use drama, theater, acting and so forth. Later, early 1997, we were introduced to this puppeteering. We made our own puppets. This is through the use of socks, and then we saw all those to make puppets. It was just the hand puppets. So from there until now, we have reached so many places throughout Fiji and even the islands.
14, 15, 16, 17, 18,
Through the use of puppets, we were able to reach out to the interior on this marijuana campaign. We have been dealing with this issue since 2000, and also filariasis, which is one of the vector-borne diseases. Also, dengue fever. We have dealt with HIV/AIDS, sexually transmitted infections, and also some other issues, environmental issues, during the days which is celebrated by most of these government ministries, whether it's to do with the Ministry of Environment, the Ministry of Health, also to do with the disaster. During our awareness, we go out into the community and do disaster awareness through the medium of puppet shows.
Puppetry is something that's totally new to me. I've worked in many other fields, and puppetry, I've seen puppet shows being performed before, but I never knew how difficult it was to actually put on a show until I've attended this training. It's the script, working on the script, putting a story together, working on the characters, and the handling of the puppets. It was stressful, but I'm managing. And I hope to learn whatever else I could in these 7 days that I'm here in Suva. And what I'm actually wanting to do is to go back to my branch, go back to my community in Lautoka, and perform puppet shows, get messages across to people. The messages that we are actually working on, what we're going to do, what we're going to present to the communities are basically on drugs, marijuana, sexually transmitted diseases, HIV and AIDS, and also the Red Cross as a whole.
So I'm not anywhere else.
My name is Leo Prop. I'm the head of the regional delegation for the Federation here in the Pacific, in our office in Suva. I would like to get more involved with puppeteering in the region. I think it's a brilliant tool that could be used very effectively in getting some of our messages across. I hope that we can develop more capacity in this area in the region. I'm not a puppeteer myself. I've got no experience in it at all. I'm not very creative in that sense, but I have seen it being used elsewhere, and I've always been very impressed. I think it's a brilliant tool to use, and I think it can bridge barriers and divides across cultures, across languages, working with different communities, and it can really help the Red Cross to get its messages across, to work on areas like HIV/AIDS, that's an obvious one, but also in areas where we haven't worked with puppeteering before. Areas including disaster preparedness and including risk reduction in communities, maybe also on the promotion of humanitarian values, on Red Cross principles, on issues like non-violence. I think there are lots of opportunities. I think there is tremendous scope. There's also a lot of enthusiasm. So I think the basic ingredients are there, and it's up to us to take this further and look at what can be done. But I'm really excited about the prospects of working more with puppeteering as a tool, as a methodology. I think it goes very well with what the Red Cross wants to achieve and what it stands for. And I think maybe the most important thing of all, you can do this with volunteers, and I think that is another important aspect for me. I think once you've got the basics in place, once you've got good scripts, once you've got ideas, once you've got some basic equipment, puppeteering is probably something that you can carry out with relatively minor recurrent expenditure. You don't have to pump in large amounts of money to keep this going. This is something that you can do in a branch with local volunteers once you've got the basic investment, the basic bits and pieces that you need in place. Every branch, every group of volunteers should be able to run with this and develop it further themselves and carry it out and maintain it. So I think that fits in very well with their ideas on branch development, on getting more volunteers involved in the Red Cross. I think it's attractive for volunteers. It can bring in new people into the Red Cross, and I think that in itself is very important as well. Apart from what we might be able to achieve with this in terms of getting our messages across, raising public awareness about the issues that, that concern us. So, sounds very interesting, very excited about it, and let's take it step by step and see what we can do.
So, we're going to put together a production, let's say an educational production for a community. So, what we need to know is, what are the fundamental principles? What do we have to do first? What is the first thing that we have to think about? And then all the pros, the steps that we got to go through to make this actually happen. Okay, now keep moving around as well. Keep moving around. So you can talk and move around. Look, keep looking at each other and keep your levels. Always looking down, keeping your levels. So go move up. I know you're small, but try your best. Okay.
Would you like to go?
Level up.
Would you like to go with me tonight?
Yeah, sure. Where to?
To the nightclub.
Okay, let's go.
I have learned many new things, and especially how to write a script that is from doing following the stages that we should take into consideration in writing a script, so that we can bring the message across to the people.
The first time I got involved with the Red Cross Papa Team was in 1997, when I had a program which aimed to train youth in Papert and theatre to address health-related issues. And I first met Temo, who is the youth leader, who was the youth leader then and who still is. And we helped train him in Papert, but knowing Temo, he took it way beyond, and he's worked with the Red Cross and he's carried on the idea and has brought the Papert Group to where it is now.
In Fiji, in the Pacific, including Fiji, most of the members, community members, are illiterate. They don't go to schools for certain reasons. Through the medium of puppet shows, it's only action up there and talk. And it's easier for audience to understand whether they don't know how to read or don't know how to write. They can get the information. And also, the other reason why puppet show is effective is because we use the language that they understand. We talk their talk.
Kulaminaka, ladies and gentlemen, this story is about how marijuana changed Sean's life. Sit back nicely and listen carefully. Thank you.
What's that smell? You've been smoking marijuana? I don't want that rubbish.
Go away! I don't like you anymore.
So we get the feedback, it's evaluated, we get the feedback from the community, and then we work on that. For example, just for an example, when we were doing this marijuana campaign, I did not go with the puppet team, but I went back to my community, and what I heard was Red Cross came to our school and they talk about the tarawau. Tarawau is a fruit. And that gave me the idea that the message was not clear. So I came back, sat down with the team, and I mentioned, maybe it's just the pronunciation of the words. So the pronunciation of the word, the factual information, and how they handle the puppet, the movement, and so forth, these are the things that we improve through the feedback, from the communities or audience.
The puppet program and the puppet theatre, such as it is, I realised was a perfect tool and the best tool for getting messages out. I've been living in Fiji now 30 years and I've never seen such audience response other than visiting royalty from the United Kingdom or the odd church person that comes, but puppet theatre does attract audience, and I could see that it's such a powerful medium, it must be used more and utilized more.
The most effective and successful one, education, was to do with dengue fever. We covered the whole of the central division that's in Witilevu, and also in the along the Coral Coast. We cover, our target was to complete all the primary schools and secondary schools, and we missed out only about 15% of the schools and also the community. So while we are there, we cover the schools during the day, and in the evening we go into the local communities to inform the communities of what we told the students.
The Puppet Theatre was originally in 2000 set up as Puppets for Peace. We did have two aborted coups here, or one aborted coup in 2000. It wasn't particularly coup because they didn't get what they required or what they wanted. However, it really polarized the racial groups in Fiji. So we put them out as Puppets for Peace. They were giving messages about the Red Cross, our principles, independence, neutrality, and we're talking about about people getting their racial differences behind them.
At the end of the workshop, we would like them to be fully equipped in skills, as far as puppet handling is concerned, how to write scripts from the beginning till it's pre-tested, field tested before it actually goes out in the community. In short, it's just for the participants to know the steps taken for a quality puppet show to be delivered in the community.
In this workshop, I've learned so much about how to handle puppets and even how to write scripts. Before, I've been attending this puppet group since 5 months now. As Gary come, he's been teach me how to write script and how to do drama and how to handle puppets. And I hope end of this workshop, I learn much.
Gary, it's very, very easy to evaluate. You just see the numbers of people that attend the shows and the demand. Of course, we have not done an evaluation exercise per se to see whether that message was retained by the audience. But to go up to a very country, very, very isolated area and get 2,000 young youth there, or youth there, watching shows on marijuana, something must be retained by the audience.
We've been learning all this time through experience. There hasn't been any training as such to train the whole team as far as running the puppet program. We have been learning on the spot and also through experience. So if you get feedback regarding the way to put on how we are running the works, running our puppet program, and try to develop into a higher ground, that's basically what we are trying. We are trying to improve.
In the future, Gary, we're going to have an HIV/AIDS problem. We cannot get out the awareness enough. I don't know what's happened in Africa, whether it would be worse situation had there not been medium of peer educators using the puppets. But our figures, our reported cases have jumped alarmingly. Fiji's only a population of 750,000 people. At this stage, at this time last year, we had 105 reported cases of HIV/AIDS. We've now got 129. The medical department statistics are for one every reported, there are minimum 10 not reported. The stigma here is absolutely appalling with HIV/AIDS. We are doing a home-based care program, and we find that our clients are completely ostracized from their community, from their village, and there's still a huge stigma attached. So again, if we can get more out in the community, STIs, but HIV/AIDS especially.
It's been a good opportunity for me to come and just get some knowledge and insight on puppetry and what all drama theatre is about. My past experience here has been, 6-7 days now, has been really challenging, tiring, and very hectic, but I've enjoyed it on a whole. I can say that I've learned very valuable lessons from people like Gary and Temu and the team here at National Office. And it's one of my desires to work with youth and using puppetry. I see now that maybe this is the way to go, since our community is quite sensitive in places around Fiji. And I think using puppets to get messages across, such as drugs, use of drugs and STIs, AIDS, is the way to go nowadays.
Because it's being run as a volunteer basis, that we have attrition. These youngsters, the youth that we're using as puppeteers, find permanent employment, they move on, and we're forever training new puppeteers, and it really does make it difficult for continuity and sustainability of the program.
In the future, we would just like to learn how to maintain the interest of the group, and also to see what to look at when we recruit our puppeteers. So that's very important, because what we've been seeing is these changes every time in the puppeteers. And it makes our work hard, because in every new recruit we have to retrain. And that will take us 3 steps back, and then we move forward. So that has been the trend. But to keep the interest of the puppeteers, maybe to leave them, give them some ideas to stay, or maybe give them the interest to stay before we move on to the next stage, which is to develop the puppet program to the next level.